Hello student, I am Purnima and once again I am in front of you. Student, yesterday we were doing a new topic and that was notice writing. After a long time I am teaching you writing section. Now children, notice writing, I have already explained about it and I will be explaining about it right now. So many things in details, okay. But let me ask you one thing. Are you enjoying all this online teaching? Isn't it a new experience for you and for us also? For us teacher, we are also having a new experience, a new way of teaching, isn't it? But still, I remember that when we were in, when I was teaching in a class in front of you, that was the day which I really enjoyed. But today also, children, I am enjoying to teach you in this new manner. Children, let me tell you one thing, life is a way how you make it. Once again I repeat my thought, life is a way how you make it. Okay, there will be many ups and downs in life. Try to accept it, try to enjoy it. So with this I am going to start my lesson, that is notice writing. Now children, this is not a new lesson for you, you have been studying, but only thing I am going to give you some tips how to write a good notice. And children, some tips will be there if you will remember, like so many tips I will be just teaching you. And again I will be revising the most important points which I had already done yesterday, but once again I am going to revise. And children, you will see that notice writing is not a very hard thing to write. Okay, people think writing is a hard thing, but children, few tips and with good language you can get a good marks in the writing section. So children, I begin my lesson with notice writing. And children, but let me tell you, first of all, once again I revise my work, I would like to tell you what is a notice. Okay, so children, a notice is a written or printed news. It should be news or information. So children, what is a notice? Notice is a written or printed news or information, right? So what is a notice, children? It is a type of information, this is the most important word, or it is a printed news, right? So what is a notice? A notice is a written piece of printed news, children. Notice, you can, why I am telling about printed news? Because some children, sometime we get information from the newspaper also, like about COVID-19, what are the timing for the lockdowns, what are the days for the lockdown. Okay, so these are some of the printed news and the information which we get from the government, okay, to the public. So this is one example I'm giving, there might be many others. Okay, like suppose you are going and you have lost your bag. In that bag many important documents were there, like your I card, your mark sheet, your PAN card, I card, Aadhaar card, so many things were there and you are unable to find it. So children, what people do, they just give a printed information, they write a notice in the newspaper, and through that notice they would like to tell the people to help them, they're finding their things. So children, notice can be a printed, it can be a printed news, or it can be an information. Now children, information can be given not only to the public, information is given in the school or colleges also. Okay, like children, you used to get notice, the timing, winter timing is changed. Now you have to put, you wear your summer uniform. 26 January you have to put white uniform. The timings, everything, whatever it comes, whatever information you get in the school and colleges, that information, okay, is a notice. So I hope this is clear to you. What is a notice, student? A notice is a written or printed news or information. This is very important, because you people are the students and you have to write notice. Generally the school notices will come in the examination, not the public notices of the newspaper. So for you this is more important, okay, the information, how you share that information in the school or colleges. Now children, second thing, it can be announcement in the school or public. Just now I've told this also, that announcement can be in the school also, announcement can be in the public also. A notice is written in simple and formal language. And this is also very important part of notice writing. It is written in a very simple language and in a very formal language. There are some particular words which I will be telling you how to start a notice, how to start a good, how you will start writing a good notice. Children, then it should be clear, what brief and relevant. The notice is, I think everybody know, you don't have to write more than 50 words, so it is brief. It should be relevant. Relevant means all the important information, whoever gets the notice, they should know. Okay, and then it should be clear. The person who is going to read a notice, it should be clear to them that this notice is about what. Okay, everything, all the information, timing, day. Okay, so this is some of the important things which I have told you about notice writing. Now student, I am going to tell you what type of notice can come in your examination. So I told you there are many notices are there. So children, various type of notices will be there, which I will be giving you some tips. Yesterday I've told you about the format and how to write one notice. Okay, so children, different type of notice which I will be giving you some tips, and that can come in the examination. I'm going to discuss it here. So first children, first type of notice is related with events or happening. Children, that means children, whatever important event or happening is there in your school, that the principal and the teachers, they tell the student in the form of a, that important information is given in the form of a notice. So children, whatever important events like celebration, that how you are going to organize a tea plantation in your school, okay, so this can become under the category of happening. Then how you celebrated 15th national festival like 15 August and 26 Jan, who was the chief guest, all the important information should be there. Of course children, one notice is there related with, then children, in events, this type of events can come if any cultural program is there, okay, like group song competition, okay, inter house or orchestra competition. There are so many competition will be there, or inter house debate competition, inter house drawing competition. So many competition are related with sports and children, with all these activities will comes to you in the form of a notice. Essay writing competition, creative writing competition. So many competition you face, and the information you get, that information is known as notice. Okay, now children, then another type of notice can come in the examination, and that is your tours and travels. Children, you are going for a picnic, or you are going to tour or excursion, like children, you have to go to Agra or Mathura to see the Taj Mahal. Okay, that means whenever you go for educational tour, how that notice is written, that I will be telling you. Of course, children, the third type of notice is, children, when you lost something in the school. The third type of notice is when you lost something in the school, like your pen is lost, your diary is lost, your geometry box is lost, or your water bottle is lost. Okay, then what, how you have to write the notice, that I will be telling you. Of course, students, the fourth type is notice is found. So children, found. Now children, now you will be thinking how the people write this type of notice and what people find in the school. So there are many things are found in the school. Suppose in the recess is over and you are coming and you can see a student has lost his tiffin or water bottle, or and you have found it. That particular person must have forgotten his blazer. He took out his blazer while playing and he rushed to the class when the bell rang and you were coming and you found that the blazer is lying in the playground. So you took that blazer, you found that blazer. So how you have to write that notice, that you have found that blazer, and how should you convey this message to the students? How you are going to convey this message? So this type of notice also I am going to teach you. Children, then there are many other things are there, like children, donate money for the to the Prime Minister Fund. If suppose it's if an accident take place, train accident is there, and children, you have to donate your blood. Okay, so student, this such type of notice also I think I have to teach you, because it may come in your examination. Okay, so these were the all important information related to notice writing. Now yesterday I told you one notice about event, inter-house debate completion. So today again, children, I will be starting my notice with events and happening. One more notice I will be telling you. Okay, but before children, I tell you about the notice, I think I will revise the format. Children, in the writing section, in all the writing section, children, we have particular format. There is a marks for format also. So you have to learn that particular format. And in my last video, I have given you the format of notice writing. Children, if you remember, what was that format? That you have to draw a box. Okay, you have to draw a box, student. And children, first three line. Okay, I think I will revise you on the board and then you will remember it. So children, first thing what you have to do, you have to draw a box. A square box. Okay. And then first line you have to leave. And then children, you have to write the name of the institution. In capital letter. So you have to write the name of the students in, children, in capital letter. Okay, of course, student, you have to write, children, then notice in the center, and then you have to write title or heading. Okay, here you have to write the date, like today is 14th July 2020. See the way I have written the date. This is the manners, student, you have to write the date. Okay, if you will write the date in some other manner, you can might get less mark. This is the new format for writing the notice. Like you have to write the full date, 14th July, small comma, 2020. Okay. So name of the institution you have to write, and then you have to write notice, then you have to write the heading. Of course, student, these three things should be written in the capital letter. These three things should be written in the capital letter, right? And then children, we come to the main important point in notice, and that is the content. in content, children. First of all, children, I will be sharing you a common language. There are so many ways to write a notice, but children, I will be telling you one line. So if you will remember that line, you will never how to write the initial, the first few words while writing your content in the notice writing. So children, you can write one word, you can start with this sentence. All the students are hereby informed. There are many ways to write the notice, okay? And then children, you can continue with the important contents. You can, okay, contents and information. So children, it is the most, what I feel, it is the easiest language and everybody can remember it. All the students are hereby informed that. Now children, you have to start your notice with the whatever the heading was. Okay, if a debate competition is going to take place, so you can start, all the students are informed here that an inter-house English debate is going to take place, right? So children, in this manner you can start your notice. Or if there is some other competition like inter-house singing competition, again you can start your notice like that. Okay, then children, there are many ways other to write the start the notice. Like the literary club of our school is going to organize the debate competition. Okay, so and there are many ways, like the in charges of the houses have decided to organize an event. Okay, so there are many ways, and I don't think the many ways, there are many ways to start the notice, but this what I feel is the easiest and the simplest way to start the notice. Now student, you have to write the notice. The important information should be there, like when. Okay student, so I have told you the starting of the notice, a very simple way to start the notice. Now I will be telling you student about the next step. And what is that next step? That all the information should be there when you write a notice, like date, time, when. Children, you have to start to write a good notice. I'm giving you one tip. Student, you ask the question by yourself. When, where, how, okay. So these are some of the way that you can never miss the point then. Okay, where, when, that is time, venue, that is place, okay, what is going to start there, okay. So these are some of the tips which I have given you to write a good notice. Okay, if you will ask this few questions, you will never miss any point. That is all the information you can write, because the examiner see that all the important information is there, all the important points are there in a notice. Which a notice, a good notice should be brief, clear and relevant. I told you relevant means children, all the important information should be there. Okay, then children we have to, after writing the content, I've given you the important tips how to write the content. Children, then what will happen? Then you have to leave one line, and then you have to write name and of course designation. Okay, and then you leave one line and close your box. So finally children, your notice will end with a name. And the last and the most important thing is designation. Now what is a designation children? Designation tells you what you are. Okay, if you are a secretary of a sports club, so you have to write it here, secretary of a sports club. If you are a president of a cultural club, then you have to write your name your full name, and then you have to write that you are the secretary of the, you are the president of the cultural club. So children, in this way I have given you all the important information related with a good notice. So students, now I am going to give you a tip once more that how you will write one notice related with events or happening. Okay, now let me think. Yes, I am going to give you a notice, and please hear me first. And children, when you read the question related with notice, you see what things are given there. Name of the institution is given or not? We will start with the name of the institution. If the name of the institution is given, children, then fine, you write, you start your notice with the name of the institution. But if it is not given, so you can write the name of your school or any other school along with the place. Then children, second point I told you, you have to write notice. Third again is the most important thing, you have to give a thought to it, and that is the title of the notice. That also you can get from the question. That's why I'm telling you, please read the question thoroughly. Okay, you have to see, in fact you have to note it down, what are the things are given in the question. Okay, then you have to see, children, if it is an inter-house or inter-school notices is there or not, and the notice is about which event, right? Then again, children, you have to see the name, that is the person, what is the name of that person who is writing a notice, what is the name of that person who has written the notice, and what is his designation. Okay, so children, I'm going to give you one example for this. Okay, so let me tell you, children, I'm going to read a question, and you all will listen question very carefully. In fact, take a pencil or a pen, and children, when I will read the question, you yourself will know that these are the important points. You note those important points there. Okay, so I begin by reading a question, and that question, children, when I will be reading, what you have to do, students, what you have to do, you have to jot all the important points, you have to write all the important points, and then you can see how many things you get from the question. Okay, so I'm going to read the question, try to listen carefully. You are Ravi or Rachna? Now children, this is a very common way to start a question. You are Ravi or Rachna? If you are a boy student, you have to write the name Ravi. Okay, and if you are a girl, then you have to write the name Rachna. Okay, so this too is clear. As president of the cultural forum of your school. Now children, again we get the very important information we are getting here in this question. We are getting two information till now. We have got two information till now. First of all, name of the person who had written the notice. Okay, see, once again I read. The question is, you are Ravi or Rachna? As president of the cultural forum of your school, you have to organize an inter-school orchestra competition. Okay, so how many information you had? Who had written the notice? If you are a boy, write the name Ravi. If you are a girl, write the name Rachna. And student, you have to write the designation also. We are getting it here. What is the designation we had here? We are having the designation, president of the cultural forum of your school. President of the cultural forum of your school. And you have organized an inter-school orchestra competition. So children, it is not inter-house, but it is a inter-school orchestra competition. So you can get the title also from here. So how many things we are getting? We are getting the name of a person who has written the notice. And children, what else we got? We are getting the designation, that what that person is. Then children, we are getting that this notice is, you have to write about what. Okay, so you have to write about the inter school orchestra competition. Then you have to, once again I read, on the occasion of the Silver Jubilee celebration of your school. Children, why this competition is being held on the occasion of Silver Jubilee celebration. Silver Jubilee, the children, you have, the, your school has completed 25 years, has completed of your school, and on this occasion it is organizing Silver Jubilee celebration. Okay. Now, student, one more thing is written in the question, and that is, write a notice in about 50 words. Generally, children, we all know that the notice is written in 50 words only. Okay, informing the students of your school about this competition. And children, what you will be informing and to whom? This is not a public notice. Now remember, this is a notice, a school notice, and you have to give the information to the students of your school. Okay, so I have given you all the, see how many things you are getting here. Name of the person who has written the notice, designation of the person of notice, on which occasion it is, the occasion of Silver Jubilee, the school is celebrating the inter-school orchestra competition. And children, also that is the designation, who is the person who has written this notice, who had given this notice to the student of a school or a college. The name of the school. Now, what not is given here? So children, first you have to see what things are given here. Now you have to say what things are not given here, and then what you have to write by your own. So first of all, student, the name of the institution is not given here. And children, that means you have to write the name of any institution along with the place. The name of the institution, and then you have to put a small comma, and then you have to write the name of the place. Okay, and I think maximum everything is given, the date, venue, time, and participants. This you have to give by yourself. So this, the major information is not given. Okay, and the name of the institution is not given, right? So children, you have, whenever the notice come, you have to see which things are given and which things are not given. Now children, how you will start the notice, this notice. Okay, so first you have to draw a box. You have to draw a box, student. And children, you have, for just for neatness, it is not a rule, you have to leave a first line. I'm just telling, it is not a rule, okay, of the format. It is simply your, when you write in the answer script in the board examination, it should be a neat and clear picture of notice. So you have to draw a box, and student, you have to leave one line also. Okay, and of course children, the name of the institution is not given, so you can write the name of any institution. You can write the name of your institution along with the place. You can write the name of any other institution, but the place should be there. So I think we will write the name of our institution, isn't it, student? So let's start. You will leave the first line, and then army in the capital letter, children, remember. Okay, you have to write everything in the capital letter. Army Public School. Of course, we have to put a small comma, and we have to write the place also. Right? So we have written the place also, Army Public School, Varanasi. The next thing, children, we are going to write notice in the center, and that too with the capital letter. Now, children, you have to think about the heading. Heading, almost you can take help. It is written clearly, an inter-school orchestra competition. Okay, so this is the best thing. We can take this only as a heading. So what you will write as a heading? Inter house orchestra competition. try to finish in one line only, try to write in one line only, that would be much neat. It will look much good, more nice, okay. Until and here you have to write the date, 14th July, small comma 2020. So children, you don't have to underline, I'm just underlining. So you can see the different, the date it must be written. And since the space is not here, so you can see this, you have to try to write in the question paper, the answer script in one line, inter-house orchestra competition. So children, all the initial part of the notice according to the format I have told you. Okay, so what is a format I have told you? The format was, you have to write the name of the institution, you have to write notice, and you have to write the heading. Now children, you can write, you can start your notice either in two ways. Either you start, all the students are here by inform that an inter-school orchestra competition is going to be held on which date. First information, which date and where. Venue is very important, okay. So children, that competition, or you can also start your notice somewhat like that, on the occasion of Silver Jubilee celebration, an inter-house orchestra competition will be held on, write the date, okay. Venue, then next thing you have to write the venue. Of course, the third thing children, you have to write the time. And the fourth thing children, you have to write how many participants can be in one group. It can be five participants, it can be four participants, it can be seven participants, okay, whatever, how many type of participants. So with this children, and one more important thing which I think many students they forgot to write, that is last day for submission of entry form is. Till many people they think, oh, lot of time is there, I will keep whenever. No, lot of thing has to be arranged. So you have to write in the notice that last day for submitting the entry form is, okay, 5 August 2020. So in this way children, and then finally you have to leave one line. And then you have to write the name children, students, you have to write the name. Now what name was given? If you were a girl, you have to write it. You have to write which name? Yes, you should write Rachna. And if you are a boy, you should write Ravi. If surname is there, you write surname. Children, one more thing. If name is not given, or like a name of institution, you can write any fake name. Any name you can write along with the surname. And finally, children, the most important thing is the designation in a notice. So, children, what was the designation? Did you remember the question? It was president of the cultural forum. So, who had written that notice? It is the, he or she is the president of the cultural forum. And then last, before closing your box, you leave one line just for neatness, and then you close your box. Children, if you will write the notice in this manner, definitely you will get good marks. Nobody can cut your marks. So this is one tips how to write a notice related with events and happenings. In my two videos, I have discussed two notice along with the important tips how to write, how to begin a notice in a very, easy manner. And if you will follow those tips, definitely student, you will get good marks. And in tomorrow's videos, I will be teaching some other types of notice also. So now I'm going to conclude my video here. Thank you and have a nice day ahead. And children, remember, it is the way you make yourself in your life. Okay? You have to find your ways. If you will not find your ways, the life would be difficult for you. So try to make your life easy and comfortable by working hard. So with this, I conclude my video here. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.